Hello everybody, welcome to the YouTube channel of Maratha Vidya Prasarak Samaj, KTHM College, Nashik. I am Dr. Jayashree Bandel from Department of Microbiology, KTHM College, Nashik here. We are going to study the course of Enzymology Paper 3 as per the SPPU syllabus of TYBSC class Semester 1. We are studying the Chapter 1 Enzymes. And the topic 2 of this chapter deals with the role of vitamins as cofactors in metabolism. In today's lecture, we are going to study the role of thiamine as a cofactor in metabolism. In today's lecture, we shall go through the historical aspects of the discovery of the vitamin, its occurrence in various natural resources, structure related to its biochemical role, causes of the deficiency diseases and their symptoms, and the recommended dietary allowance of this particular vitamin. To introduce the vitamin was vitamin B1, that is thiamine, was the first amongst the B group of vitamins to be identified. Thus, it has got the name vitamin B1. As we studied earlier, vitamins cannot, as they are, play a role in metabolism. Thus, they need to be converted to the active coenzyme forms. So, the thiamine has to be converted to thiamine pyrophosphate TPP, which plays the role of the active coenzyme form in the metabolic reactions. The dietary sources of this vitamin include the unpolished whole grains, milk products, and yeast. We have seen the role of the polished and unpolished grains, especially rice, in the discovery of thiamine. It plays an important role in carbohydrate metabolism, energy production, and as we know, it therefore plays an important role in the supply of energy for the various functions in the body. Heart muscles, appropriate functioning of the heart muscles, formation of RBCs, and there are many other functions related to this. To go very briefly through the historical aspects, it was Takiki Kanihiro in 1884 who hypothesized that beriberi was caused due to some deficiency in the nutrition or in the diet. Thus, it was further Christian Eichmann who hypothesized that beriberi was due to some nutritional deficiency. Then next in the row was Christian Eichmann, who said that, or who demonstrated that beriberi is caused by poor diet, that is again some nutritional deficiency, and this further led to the discovery of antineuritic vitamins. For this contribution, he won a Nobel Prize for Physiology and Medicine in 1924. It was Gerrit Grinz in 1901 who was the co-discoverer of vitamin B1, and Casimir Funk, who has immense contribution in the discovery of vitamins and their role in metabolism. He was the first to formulate the concept of vitamins, which he called vitalamines or vitamines. We have studied in our earlier introductory part that the vitamines are no longer called as vitamines. Instead, we call them as vitamins because all the vitamins were not amines. To lead further in the development of thiamine and its metabolic role, it was B.C.P. Janssen and William Donath in 1926 who isolated the antiberiberi factor in the crystalline form from rice polishings, and they named it thiamine. Why thiamine was elucidated by Robert Williams in 1934. It was named as thiamine because it contains a sulfur group or a thio group. So, being a sulfur containing vitamin, it is called as thiamine. Phillips and his colleagues in 1936, they synthesized in the laboratory chemical synthesis of thiamine. It was Laumann and Juster in 1937, they identified the role of thiamine pyrophosphate in the oxidative decarboxylation of pyruvate. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase. Thus, thiamine pyrophosphate serves as a coenzyme for the activity of pyruvate dehydrogenase. We have already studied in last year about the role of pyruvate dehydrogenase in detail. The mechanism of action of thiamine in cellular metabolism, not only dietary deficiency, but what exactly is its role in the cellular metabolism which leads to the deficiency symptoms was thus elucidated or illustrated. It was Ronald Breslow in 1958 who studied the correct place or the correct site of reactivity of thiamine pyrophosphate in enzymes that promote the decarboxylation of pyruvate, that is in pyruvate dehydrogenase. Where exactly is the role of thiamine diphosphate and which part of the thiamine diphosphate actually plays the role of the coenzyme or actually plays the role in activity of pyruvate dehydrogenase to oxidatively decarboxylate the pyruvate. The natural sources which are rich in thiamine contain the various kinds of nuts, okay, almonds and all these nuts, brown rice, that is unpolished rice, whole grain products, so you don't have to sieve your atta. You have to use it without sieving. Don't throw away the husks. The seed coats of many plants, including, as I am talking about, the cereal grains and legumes. In addition, the animal products like the animal liver, the kidney, and milk, which we get from animals, and the seafoods also are rich in thiamine. Polishing of the rice removes almost 80% of the thiamine. So it is very good to include brown rice or less polished rice in our daily diet. Thiamine is water soluble. And so when you are cooking these products, if you are adding a large amount of water and throwing it out, most of the times, in most of the places, especially while cooking the rice, they add a large amount of water, and once the rice is boiled, they just throw away the water and then the rice is cooked using steam. But this will obviously remove all the remaining vitamin from the rice. So because it being water soluble, it seeps out, it comes out in the water while cooking. And if you throw out this water, you are throwing out the vitamin present in that particular food product. Yeasts and animal tissues contain this vitamin in the form of TPP. So they are easily available to the metabolic functions in a cell. Now let us see the structure of the vitamin to understand its biochemical role. So here you see that there is a pyrimidine. We have studied the structure of purines and pyrimidines last year, and this is the thiazole ring which contains the sulfur. In the earlier slide I said that it is a sulfur containing vitamin. So this is the part of the vitamin which plays an important role in metabolism. And both these rings are joined by a methylene bridge. Now this thiamine is converted to its active coenzyme form thiamine pyrophosphate by the enzyme TPP synthetase. Here you will see that it is the pyrophosphate which is added to the alcoholic group of the thiamine. So thiamine consists of a pyrimidine ring and a thiazole ring which is joined by a methylene bridge. Then two phosphate molecules, they bind thiamine to convert it to the coenzyme form thiamine pyrophosphate or cocarboxylase. To understand the biochemical function, we need to emphasize on the role of the thiazole ring and its conversion to the carbanion form, that is deprotonation. Here you can see this proton is removed, and the whole of the metabolic function or its role as the coenzyme is because of this conversion. So let us see this in detail. In all the TPP mediated reactions, the site of action is C2. Here you can see this carbon atom of the thiazole ring. The hydrogen atom here tends to dissociate as a proton to form a carbanion. So this, see, the important part is this hydrogen atom is not dissociating as a complete hydrogen atom. Instead, it is dissociating as a proton, leaving behind the electron. And so it is called as the carbanion ion. So you need to understand this conversion first to understand the further role in metabolism. The carbanion then participates in the decarboxylation of pyruvic acid in this way. So here you will see CH3 C double bond OCOH is pyruvate. You have studied it last year. This pyruvate binds at this particular place where there is a chance of binding because of the negative charge off on the atom because of the electrons that are left. So this forms a compound. So the pyruvate binds to the carbanion form and forms a compound which is called as the addition product. The addition product now is decarboxylated. The basic role is decarboxylation of pyruvate, and this decarboxylation cannot be done by the enzyme in absence of the coenzyme TPP because it is the carbanion form which is needed for binding of the pyruvate to the carbanion form, and then only it can be decarboxylated. So here we shall see the decarboxylation step. Now we have seen this the pyruvate binding to the carbanion form. This is the addition product, and the decarboxylation then takes place, again leaving a lone pair of electrons here, and the CO2 is removed. These reactions depend on the collection of negative charge, here you see, on the carbonyl carbon, where exactly the cleavage occurs. Can you see here? The cleavage has occurred here. And so this is due to the collection of negative charges there. Thionine pyrophosphate helps these reactions by stabilizing the negative charge. The acetaldehyde thus dissociates from the acetaldehyde also dissociates. After the decarboxylation has been done, it is the acetaldehyde molecule which is present along with the addition product. So this also eventually dissociates from the addition products, and the carbanion form is regenerated. The resonance stabilized intermediate can be protonated to give the hydroxyethyl TPP. So here you can see this is the resonance stabilized form. One proton is added here to form the hydroxyethyl intermediate of thiamine pyrophosphate. And then the quaternary nitrogen of thiazolium group, it provides the electrostatic stabilization by removal of the C2 proton. So at the end of the reaction, you have removed the CO2. So the pyruvate has been decarboxylated and eventually it is converted to acetaldehyde. The reaction, so that was a major biochemical role which we need to understand. And now we shall see the various reactions in which the thiamine pyrophosphate participates as a coenzyme. So it functions as a coenzyme of the alpha keto dehydrogenases. To exemplify, we have pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. We have already studied it in detail earlier. The alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase complex also we have studied along with the TCA cycle. The pyruvate decarboxylase, transketolase, and the phosphoketolases. So now children, now let us go and see exactly the reactions catalyzed by these enzymes. Before that, we shall see the role of thiamine pyrophosphate in the central energy yielding metabolism. So we know that glucose is it enters the EMP pathway and it enters the HMP pathway. The reducing power generated in the form of NADH2, NADH plus H plus and NADPH2, they then are passed towards the electron transport chain and the energy is generated. But it starts with the EMP or HMP. So in the EMP, the important step for converting the pyruvate to acetyl-CoA, which is a link between the electron transport, between the EMP pathway glycolysis and the TCA cycle, is importantly mediated by the phosphate dehydrogenase complex, of which TPP is an important coenzyme. Same is the case with alpha-keto dehydrogenase complex, which also requires TPP. And transketolase is important in the pentose phosphate pathway or the HMP pathway. So, just understand, students, that if your diet is deficient of the thiamine pyrophosphate or thiamine, all these pathways will be functionless or they will not perform properly. And that will definitely reflect upon the energy generation. And all the functions of our body need an adequate source of energy and adequate supply of energy to perform optimally. So we shall now exemplify each reaction that it catalyzes. So the first enzyme is pyruvate dehydrogenase, which converts pyruvate to acetyl-CoA, which we have seen earlier. So this pyruvate is converted to acetic acid, which further joins with the coenzyme A to be converted to acetyl-CoA. So this reaction, we have seen the details, intermediate steps of the reaction is catalyzed by TPP as the coenzyme. And this is an important link between the EMP pathway and the TCA cycle. The next in the row is alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase enzyme, which converts alpha-ketoglutarate to succinate. This is the reaction which we have seen as a part of the TCA cycle. Here also this enzyme requires TPP as the coenzyme. The pyruvate decarboxylase, it converts pyruvate to acetaldehyde, which also needs thiamine pyrophosphate as the coenzyme. The transketolase enzyme is the enzyme which converts the 2-carbon fragment, removes the 2-carbon fragment from xylulose phosphate and it transfers it to D-ribose to form pseudoheptulose 7-phosphate, which is an important reaction in the pentose phosphate pathway. This enzyme also requires thiamine pyrophosphate as the coenzyme. The next is phosphoketolase, which converts xylulose 5-phosphate to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and acetylphosphate. This enzyme also needs thiamine pyrophosphate as the coenzyme. Now coming down to the causes of deficiency. In all the initial part of the lecture, I think we have understood properly how important role thiamine pyrophosphate plays in the metabolism and so how necessary it is to include the adequate amounts of thiamine in our diet. But still, deficiency of this particular vitamin can be due to disturbed absorption through the intestine due to intestinal disorders. That is, you are consuming the adequate amount of the thiamine, but it cannot be absorbed through the intestine due to certain other problems. In certain conditions like pregnancy, lactation, excessive exercise, especially by the sports person, there is an increased requirement of thiamine. And so your diet has to fulfill this. If not fulfilled, if you do not increase the amount of thiamine in your diet during these conditions, there's a possibility that you may suffer from the deficiency symptoms. Chronic alcoholism. Alcohol destroys thiamine, and so chronic alcoholism destroys thiamine and leads to deficiency symptoms. The deficiency symptoms can be listed as beriberi, fatigue, that is low in energy level. You get tired very fast. This is because you are not producing enough amount of energy. Weight loss due to the same reasons, nerve degeneration, heart problems, anorexia, and peripheral neuritis. The deficiency diseases like beriberi can be classified as wet beriberi, dry beriberi, and cerebral beriberi. In wet beriberi, you have edema, that is swelling you can see. Then tachycardia, you have difficulty in breathing, the BP increases, and if it continues without treatment, may lead to cardiac failure. In dry beriberi, you have neurological symptoms, that is your impulses are not transferred properly to the limbs, and so you can see numbness of the limbs. There is excessive weight loss and muscular weakness. In the cerebral beriberi, which is called, cerebral beriberi is a very rare symptom, because for this symptom to develop, there has to be a highly deficient diet in thiamine, and this should continue for a long period of time. Then only the symptoms of cerebral beriberi will develop. So the syndrome that develops due to the cerebral beriberi is called as Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome, where you see the memory loss. It affects the motion of the eyeballs, so the eyeballs are not moving at your command, and there is apathy. That is, you know, you feel low, you feel depressed, and all these kinds of symptoms. In polyneuritis, since the carbohydrate metabolism is affected, we know that conversion of pyruvate to acetyl-CoA, which enters the TCA cycle, this pyruvate dehydrogenase needs thiamine pyrophosphate as the coenzyme. If your diet is deficient in thiamine pyrophosphate, the carbohydrate metabolism is affected and pyruvate accumulates in the tissues because it is not converted to acetyl-CoA at the proper rate. Excess of carbohydrate now crosses the brain-blood barrier and so it enters the brain. And this affects the function of the brain, which leads to the paralysis of the peripheral and motor nerves. And you can see these symptoms of paralysis. So what precautions can we take to avoid the deficiency symptoms and deficiency of thiamine in the diet is, we should know that thiamine is destroyed by heat. So overcooking of the dietary resources, of the grains, of the pulses will destroy thiamine. And we should know that if a large percentage of thiamine is destroyed, this will add to the increased consumption of thiamine in diet. It is leached in the water because it is water soluble. So you should add less water to cook the foods. In many parts of India, rice is cooked in a different way. That is, a large amount of water is added while cooking of the rice. And once the rice boils for a particular period, the water is removed. And the rice is allowed to cook along with the steam. But most of the thiamine goes along with the water that is removed. And very less remains with the cooked rice. Use of baking soda is also not very good for preserving thiamine in the food products because it affects the activity of the vitamin. The daily requirements for adults is usually 1 to 1.5 milligrams per day, but this is not a thumb rule because in different conditions this requirement may differ. In children, it is somewhere around 0.7 to 1.2 milligrams per day. As I've said earlier, during pregnancy and lactation, it increases to 2 milligrams per day. Athletes or the sports people also require more than the daily recommended diet depending upon their physical exercise. The daily requirement of thiamine also increases with the intake of calories. Now this again relates to the biochemical role of thiamine pyrophosphate. We have seen that thiamine pyrophosphate is important. It plays a very major role in the hydrolysis of carbohydrates. And so if you are eating more amount of carbohydrates, more calorific diet, obviously the requirement of thiamine to degrade or to digest these calories will be increased. So the proportion is usually, if you are consuming 1000 calories of diet, the amount of thiamine in your diet should be 0.5 millimoles. To summarize what we have studied in today's lecture, we shall just have a fast revision of what we have studied in today's lecture. Thiamine is the first B vitamin that was identified. Its active coenzyme form is thiamine pyrophosphate. The dietary sources include whole grains, milk products, and yeast. Polishing removes about 80% of thiamine. Thiamine being water soluble is excreted from your body, not stored in the body, and so it should be included in the daily diet. It plays a vital role, a very important role in carbohydrate amino acid metabolism. Its deficiency leads to conditions like beriberi and polyneuritis. So we should take care to protect it during cooking. Diet should be sufficient to meet the daily requirements of the vitamin. So, thank you, dear students. I am very sure you have understood about the metabolic role that thiamine plays in our body, in every cell. And so, I think we have emphasized, and all of you all will take care to include the recommended amount of thiamine in your daily diet. Thank you very much.